Hi, I'm Charles with Atlas Business Solutions, and I'd like to show you how easy it is to create and assign shifts in Visual Staff Scheduler Pro and Premier. In this session, I'll demonstrate defining a new shift, assigning a shift, and erasing shift assignments. Let's start by defining a shift. You'll use shifts in VSS Pro to indicate the times that an employee works or will have time off. For instance, you might create a shift called day that begins at 6 a.m. and ends at 2 p.m. A Visual Staff Scheduler allows you to create up to 250 shifts to suit the needs of your business. We also include predefined shifts for time off, on call, and note, and these are special shifts with no start or end time. So to define a shift, we just click Define and Shifts. This will open our shifts list. And each shift includes a description, which is the name of the shift, up to 15 characters, an abbreviation, which is just a shortened form of the description. This will be used on reports and in screens where there isn't enough room to display the full description. A start time, which is when the shift begins, an end time, which would be when the shift ends, a break length, which would represent any kind of unpaid break. This is in hours, and a quick key, which would be a keyboard shortcut used to assign the shift quickly. And then also, you can choose a color if you want the shift represented in color on screen or on the reports, and this is optional. And the shift length is actually calculated by taking the total length of the shift minus the break length. So let's create a shift. We'll call it day. I'll give it an abbreviation of D, and it will start at 6 a.m., ending at 2 p.m. And we'll give it a half-hour break length. We'll use D for our quick key. We'll create another one, and we'll call it evening. We'll give it an abbreviation of E. And maybe this one is 2 to 10. So we have a couple of shifts defined, so now they're ready to use. So we can make a few shift assignments. To assign a shift, we just click on the day for the employee that we want to assign. We can select a shift from the drop-down and click the Assign button. It's as easy as that. There are actually a few different ways that you can, three basic ways to assign a shift. You can select the day and pick the shift from the drop-down menu and use the button. You can also double-click on a day and then pick the shift and fill in any other information from this assignment screen. So you can add an explanation or a note. Or you can select the day and use the quick key that we assigned earlier. So I just hit D on my keyboard and it's as the shift. There are other tools that you can use to create shift rotations and repeat shift rotations, and we can cover those in another video. They're also covered pretty well in the user guide and in the help contents, but that would be the schedule multiple and the copy multiple tool. Also, you can copy and paste shift assignments. So we just select a shift and we copy it and we can paste it. And we can also copy from one employee to another employee. So that makes it pretty easy to build out rotations quickly. You'll notice as I'm assigning these shifts that this hours column is updated, and this represents the total number of hours that are assigned within this particular view. I'm looking at 14 days right now, and Amy Johnson has 37.5 hours assigned so far in this view, and that goes back to the shift length that we talked about earlier. We've got the start time and the end time representing the overall shift length, and then we subtract out any break length. So Amy has a total of 37 and a half hours scheduled in this 14-day view. So if we decide that we need to change a shift assignment, or we need to, maybe we're swapping people around, or someone decides they can't work that day, or we just made a mistake, sometimes we'll need to maybe delete a shift assignment. And there's a couple of different ways to do that. So you can just select the shift you want to erase and click the Erase Shift button, or you can use the Delete button on your keyboard. That actually will erase everything in the cell, though, so you might want to be careful with that. You can also select the cell and just go to Edit and Erase Shift Time Off. And it's that easy. So working with shifts in VSS Pro is pretty straightforward. Each shift will need to be defined. You have 250 slots to define shifts, so most of the time that's going to be plenty to cover most scenarios. And then we just assign those shifts as necessary. So I hope that was helpful, and if you do have any questions, you can email us at support@abs-usa.com. If you have an evaluation copy of VSS, or if you're using an older version, you can contact our sales team at 1-800-874-8801, or visit our website at www.abs-usa.com. Thank you very much.